We haven't looked at a UK Transformers annual since, when was that? October 2022? Oh my goodness, I've failed you all as the authority on this topic, but we'll continue with this farce until you all learn to watch these videos in the same numbers as my other ones. The 1990 annual kicks off in style with this dynamic depiction of Megatron fighting a very dumpy Optimus Prime by Lee Sullivan. It doesn't get more Transformery than this, folks. And inside, things kick into overdrive with this fantastic rendition of Megatron absolutely destroying Optimus Prime's jigsaw. Incredibly dynamic and honestly one of my favourite renditions of Megatron. Proper nasty bastard. I do like this first page where Galvatron loses his own annual in the Rift of Time and Space because he didn't fill in the details. So let's get that over with now. Alright, there we go. We're back in familiar territory with a text-based history of the Transformers story, this time through the very strange lens of an alien school kid using his father's time machine to view the events of the Autobot-Decepticon war for a school report. We get the usual mix of artwork from the comic, and that's about it really. You know, it's a nice catch-up, but it's not exactly a high-energy opener. Although I do quite like the dark ending where the kid returns to his time and he isn't sure whether his actions have caused changes resulting in a different, nastier timeline. You need a bit of melancholy in a Transformers annual, it's tradition. Next we get a very nice mini poster reprinted from the Marvel UK Collected Comics number 6. Always a pleasure to see Jeff Senior's artwork in this. I guess all we need to do now is cut this out and hang it on the what? Ah, okay, wait a second here, there's something on the other side. Our first comic story, Destiny of the Dinobots, starting off with a truly lovely splash of the Dinobots being charged by actual dinosaurs. Dinobot Snarl is at death's door because they've been infected with a disease, so the Dinobots travel to Marvel's Savage Land to find the Control Crystal, an item that will allow them to store Snarl's mind until they can make a new body for him. So it's time to slap some dinosaurs around, it seems. They batter through their Saurian counterparts until reaching the resting place of the crystal, but, and you won't believe this, it's gone. The Dinobots find out this little fella has been using the Control Crystal to save the organic dinosaurs from another disease that is driving them bananas. Oh, it's getting thick real quick here, isn't it? So instead of taking the crystal and consigning the dinos to their fate, the Dinobots use the crystal to transfer Snarl's mind into that of an organic Stegosaurus until they can come back with a new body. And isn't that wild? Some very cute dinosaur depictions in here too. Another quite gloomy story, but ending on a hopeful note. Turning the page, we have the Autobot vs. Decepticon Duel of Wits, where it's recommended that you and another person go head to head, picking a side and seeing who can answer the most questions, as if anyone into Transformers in 1990 knew one other person. We're back in prose land for another story, starring Backstreet this time, called Trigger Happy. I'm not going to get into the story too much here, but there's some nice enough artwork. I mean, look at this picture of Prime here. Furious. Backstreet's essentially messed up, causing Autobot plans to be ruined due to a snap decision, injuring humans in the process, and he's worried that Prime's going to take away his Nintendo Switch. Next page is a double dose of MicroMaster patrol bios featuring the race car patrol and off-road patrol. I do very much prefer individual bios rather than the function of a whole team. For some reason, you know, these are kind of dull and generic. But comics time again, thank goodness, with Dreadwing down. Another story where the Autobots have caused human casualties. They need to be stopped, these Autobots. Standard Get the MacGuffin stuff here, but with some great artwork and the introduction of my genuine biological children, the Seacons. Some nice action, some moral dilemmas, and at the end Getaway says they're starting to rust in the seawater. Good. Drown ya bastard. The answer to the Duel of Wits is revealed, and who won? Well, I can tell you, as an only child in 1990, loneliness. But let's lighten the mood with this mini poster of Ultra Magnus drowning in baked beans. It must be doing a thing for comic relief, he's good like that. Trigger Happy Part 2 begins with Prime being punched directly in the family jewels. There's some fighting, Megatron poses for a nice holiday photo, and he biffs a fairground ride off Prime's head. Things end up as expected, and instead of being scolded, Backstreet is praised for being so brave. Huh. Mini poster time with a bunch of flying swines. And then we're onto the bios of the MicroMaster, Decepticon Airstrike Patrol, and the Sports Car Patrol. Decepticon teams have much more interest in details than the Autobot ones, purely because they're evil. Last comic is Chain Gang, and yes, the Decepticon pretenders are attacking an oil rig. That's the most Transformery thing a Transformer can do. A bit of a scrap breaks out with the extremely boring Autobot pretenders, who also save an aeroplane before capturing the Decepticons for trial. It's not incredible, but look at these wee folks having the best time. Then we've got the last set of MicroMaster bios, and look, come on, don't be like that. They're fine. Overall, I think this is a fairly strong annual. What it lacks in puzzle pages, it makes up for with some fun stories that have an impact on the ongoing story. There's some pretty dark imagery too, both in text and in the comics, which was always welcome as a little kid. The back inner cover is Megatron, still working away on his new project, and indeed the same can be said for the back cover. I don't know why I include these parts. I guess you might wonder what was on there if I didn't. Okay, bye.